She's a maniac, maniac on the floor. And she's dancing like she's never danced before. She's a maniac, maniac on the floor. And she's dancing like she's never danced before. And she's dancing like she's never danced before.
I paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence but committed no crime. And bad mistakes I've made a few. I've had my shouts and kicks in my face, but I've come through.
I need to go on.
We are the champions, my friends.
All right, we can wait like a minute then. For the draft to go a little bit.
I've taken my bows and my curtain calls. You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes with it. I thank you all, but it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruise. I consider it a challenge before the whole human race, and I ain't gonna lose. We are the champions.
Okay, you can start. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, to Game 2 of a Best of 3. It's Kaipe versus EG, an NA Dota showdown with some Europeans mixed in on the side of Kaipe. Game 2 is now underway. EG currently leading the Best of 3, 1-0. They took it on the back of some brilliant ganks, some great mid-game play, Bambo sniping two couriers as his nature's prophet, track kills galore. They started off the laning stage slow, but they just were much more coordinated and focused in the mid-game. So now Kuiper finds themselves in a 0-1 hole. Kuiper been playing quite well as of late, really on the rise as a team. We've seen Arteezy carrying the load a lot of games for them, but they gave him a Weaver mid last game, and Weaver is one of these heroes that there's only so much you can do. It's a bit squishy. There was a bounty hunter on the enemy side. Sure, you can time-lapse out of dust, you can time-lapse out of track, but you can't do that throughout the fights. He never had a BKB. He never had a linkage or any way to stay involved. And as a result, after a great early start, he fell off. I feel for Kuiper to be successful in game two. We'll need to see Arteezy on a much more aggressive and impactful mid-game hero, and they'll get it for him here. They pick up the Timbersaw, and they also give him a Keeper of the Light. So some great counter push, some great mobility for Timbersaw, and I think more importantly, permanent full mana for him. You can always give him more mana with the Chakra Magic. Kuiper on the Radiant side for this game, EG on the Dire. And EG will respond by going for some heroes we saw in game number one. They pick up the Treant, the Nature's Prophet as well. They really love their nature. I guess EG probably recycles, huh? Well, we'll see what else they go for. This time around, the Batrider isn't available. Last game, they opted to ban Timbersaw, having the first pick. So they secured a Bat first pick for themselves. But this time around, they had the second pick. And as a result, they don't get the Bat. They could still get the Bounty Hunter if they wanted. But the Batrider was really the crux of that strategy. Because without Batrider, EG did not really have a way to find track kills. Prophet can't really gank. Treant can't really gank. Shadow Fiend with the Shadow Blade maybe can solo kill supports, but that's about it. So we'll see what they go for here. They now ban out a Phantom Lancer. Worried about Kuiper taking an ultra late game. I can't blame them. Kotal PL is not fun. And EG don't have AoE. Treant and Prophet are not good AoE in the mid to late game against PL. So not having AoE, probably not wanting to have to pick a lineup to counter PL, they'll just opt to ban him. As for Kuiper, they ban out the OD mid, the Weaver mid, two heroes that can really make life rough for a Timbersaw in the mid game, and even in the laning stage, I should say. Timbersaw, he received a buff recently. His base int is higher, and his int gain is much better. Basically, he's got more mana for his spells. But nonetheless, OD mid is still going to crush him. Your melee hero, there's no trees to really work with, so you can't harass the OD too effectively, and pretty much you're a melee hero with no nukes against an OD with lots of damage. You ain't winning that matchup. So they'll ban out one of the harder heroes to deal with. Now Kuiper select an Alchemist. So they're going to look to actually contest EG in terms of farm and late game now. They pick up the Alc. They've got the Timbersaw. Two heroes that scale very well into the late game. Timbersaw, one of the better ways to deal with Anti-Mage as long as he has mana. And actually, hold that thought. We've got ourselves a Space Cow. Oh, baby. Kuiper has picked up Spirit Breaker. They now have a triple melee core. But I'm super excited for this. One of the better heroes against Bounty Hunter, you can charge him from across the map, and as long as you're packing dust or a gem, once you arrive, you can look to kill him. So EG, we saw the Fear Bounty Hunter. They played him as a safe laner in game number two, or rather game one. They gave him farm priority early, and in fact, he farmed a lot. He basically rushed Phase Boots and then straight into Desolator before he really got involved in many kills. He farmed it pretty quickly. We'll see if he plays a similar style. I'd reckon probably not this game since they have an Anti-Mage and a Prophet. Might even be something that Demon takes the offlane. Maybe we'll see the Fear Anti-Mage instead. As for Jayo, not sure what he'll play this game. It was a Bamboo Prophet last game. It'll probably be a Bamboo Prophet this time around. I think something like a Puck would be decent here. A pretty good hero against Alchemist. You can easily phase shift dodge a stun. Not bad against Spirit Breaker. You have the Silence, the Dream Coil. You have a lot of ways to kite him and deal with him while you wait for backup to arrive. And they definitely need a mid that's got some teamfight presence. Because right now, their only stun and their only teamfight of note is Treant's Overgrowth, which isn't even a true stun. If you don't have Lockdown against Alchemist, and you're not really far ahead in terms of items, well, you're in trouble. EG, with this draft, they can't really contest Kuiper. They're going to trade farm. Bounty Hunter, you can give him Living Armor. He can be annoying in the offlane, but he's not going to shut down an Alchemist from farming. Not with the help of the Keeper of the Light. So it'll be a free farm Alchemist most likely in the safe lane. I mean, with Spirit Breaker, you never know where that hero's going to lane. He's not a bad offlaner, though, because he starts the game with around 700 HP, and I believe it's 5 base armor. You can't really zone him out of lane without some insane tri-lane, like a Shadow Demon, Lina, Gyrocopter, some amazing burst damage, great lockdown tri-lane. But obviously, EG don't have that. So it could be a Spirit Breaker offlane, an Alchemist Keeper of the Light, safe lane. Timbersaw mid for Arteezy, and then the question is, what will the plus one be? But I'm excited. Spiritbreaker also, it's worth mentioning, is one of the best heroes in the game to gank split pushers. Prophet, even if he gets a Shadow Blade, I mentioned that you can charge a Bounty Hunter. He won't be safe from that. Same goes for an Anti-Mage. Sure, he's pretty... Really? What the hell is this game? Bloodseeker now picked up by EG. So we've got a Bloodseeker on EG's side. We've got a Timbersaw and a Spirit Breaker on Kaipi's side. I don't know who to root for. Rupture is going to be fantastic against Spirit Breaker. If you or even Timbersaw. I believe when he Timber Chains, he still takes Rupture damage. And his high base armor from Reactive Armor won't help him. And Kaipi now have three heroes that could look to build BKBs. Alchemist and Spirit Breaker almost certainly want to. Timbersaw, not always, but often you'll go for one. Well, this should be interesting. I don't think I've ever cast a Bloodseeker game in a pro match before, so I have no idea how the lanes are going to work out here, but a JO Bloodseeker will be the choice. Tell me they're not trolling. They're not trolling. We got ourselves a ball game. A quad melee lineup for Kaipi, a Bloodseeker on EG side. Both drafts are feeling a bit greedy here, but the mid game looks explosive. There's Rupture, there's Prophet, Teleport Ganks, there's Track Kills for EG side, there's Timbersaw, Alchemist, Spirit Breaker, Clockwork. There's like eight heroes in this game that just want to go and fight and kill. Then you're Keeper Light and Treant, and their job is to make the game less fun. Same for the Anti-Mage. It should be an exciting game. It's game two of a best of three. If you're just joining us, this is the Corsair Summer Tour 2013, brought to you by Beyond the Summit. The winner of this best of three moves on to play Virtus Pro in the semifinals of the winner's bracket. It's a double elimination format. It's a $10,000 tour. So the winner will take home quite a hunk of moolah. And on that note, well, you guys should all go tweet and post about this on Reddit if you'd like, because this should be an interesting match. Some very, very exciting picks. Looks like EG just wanted to one-up Kaipi with their Bloodseeker selection. Of course, the EG leading 1-0. If they take this game, they take the series. So we'll introduce the players now. Demon on the offlane Bounty Hunter. He'll have Living Armor at his side. Bambo playing the Jungle Prophet. Same build for him. Reina Basilius, two tangos. A little bit of trash talk between the players. A lot of nice pick, LOLs. And unpause comes now. JL, your solo mid Bloodseeker, been pulled heavily. Oh, sorry, not heavily, just a single set of tangos, but still given a bit of extra regen. Fear on the Anti-Mage, heading to the top lane. B-Diz playing the Treant Protector. No items aside from Observers and Sentries. Also bought the Courier. Now that's support. That is some hardcore support duty for you. On the Radiant side, we've got Kaipi, headlined, of course, by the A-God and the EE-God. Bone7 playing the Clockwork offlane. RTZ on your solo mid as the Timbersaw. So he's actually been playing a lot of in recent days. It might look odd, but for Kaipi, it's, dare I say it, almost normal. Envy on your Alchemist, heading to the safe lane. They'll run Come With Me as a support Spirit Breaker. Not a bad support hero. I mean, he's tanky. He does decent damage without items. You don't really need much to charge and set up ganks, but the hero does need levels. You really do want to max charge. You want to at least get 1 point Nether Strike. Ideally in the mid game, you'd like Empowering Haste Max for the move speed it gives to your team. And the final hero for Kaipi, it is Pylaidai playing the Keeper of the Light. So generally when you run a support Keeper of the Light, your goal is to pick a secondary support who really benefits from levels, and you tri-lane them. The reason being that the Keeper of the Light is great at clearing stacks, and therefore you want someone who takes advantage of that farm and or those levels more than others. So it's an awfully Bounty Hunter, Demon now revealed. We'll go back under cover of Invis, but here comes the charge, the stun being channeled. There's no detection. No, there is. The dust don't come with me. They found Demon. I didn't see it at first, but it'll be a first blood. Demon Dota. It's a blessing and it's a curse. Last game, it was mostly a blessing. But off the bat, you do see the power of Spirit Breaker, as I mentioned in the pregame, or in the analysis portion of the draft, rather, to just punish a Bounty Hunter. But let's be honest. You shouldn't be dying at level 1. Just showed himself, wasn't Invis. A little bit sloppy. Generally, if your invis is about to wear off, you tuck under the trees here. You tuck into this camp even. Or you can even go hide here and quickly pop the invis. But doesn't do it. Gives up a kill. So off to a slow start they'll be. But the good news is Pylaidai can stack some jungle camps for Kaipi. They'll be able to quickly get some farm on these heroes. And it'll be up to Demon to slow them down. Off lane, nothing much to see here. Anti-Mage should farm freely against Clockwork. So the mid lane's where the real fun is. JO's being charged already. Are they actually going for a kill at level 2? I can't believe it, but they are. It really is a pub. This is not even IXDL. This is just a total pub stomp, or attempt anyway. Come with me charging in mid. Diving the Bloodseeker mid. Your eyes do not deceive you. And Arteezy, well, he's like, I don't know what I'm supposed to do with this, come with me, but thanks for the gank, I guess. Come with me, we'll head back bottom. While that's happening, though, Demon can look to disrupt these pulls, can look to harass Pylaidai. The one issue with Keeper the Light as a support against Bounty Hunter is by himself, he's pretty vulnerable to the harassment. So he'll generally want Spiritbreaker by his side in these moments. As for the mid lane, Arteezy 7-0, JO 5-1. With the Quelling Blade, they have the same base damage, but Arteezy relies much more on his spells to last hit. JO is going to slowly try and wear him down. He Blood Rages him now, and Arteezy, true to form. He's always going aggressive, this guy. And he'll throw out the Whirling Death now, taking 2 points of reactive armor. As a melee versus melee, you're likely to want to trade hits. You're likely to be in the middle of the lane, and you're up against a hero who's got living armor on his side. But now Demon rotates in, and they want to make a go on Arteezy. I don't think they can kill him, but just simple harassment. Then Demon backs off and heads towards top. So all things considered, it's Envy on the safe lane, Alk, 9-4 against an 11-3. Oh, hold that thought. We've got a haste on Demon. 11-3 Anti-Mage. Generally, the Alk can do more with the farm, just because he farms much faster, and once you get a Shadow Blade, you can go for kills, whereas Anti-Mage just wants to split push. But split pushing is rather dangerous against Spirit Breaker. We'll have to see how much he can get done, and against Shadow Blade Alk in the mid game. Looks like Demon wants to snipe a courier, hiding mid. Maybe he can get the kill. I don't know if the Janata is enough. He'll need 3 more hits, rather 2 more from here. And the last hit won't be forthcoming. Courier jukes in the trees. Demon has been thwarted. Good reaction, quick reaction. Not sure who made it happen. Probably Arteezy, though. He's one of the fastest mids that I've seen, just in terms of watching a stream and seeing how quickly he can switch between the courier and his hero. It's something that makes the difference there. Otherwise, Demon, one more hit, would have gotten the kill. It was close, but Arteezy able to slow him down. Now Demon comes back mid. It's a dual lane mid. It's a party mid, but Arteezy already with 8 armor from the level 2 reactive armor. Just doesn't care about the harassment. You have living armor, Arteezy says. That's great. I don't need my supports to help me. I've got reactive armor, and that's more than sufficient. So the mid lane is pulling ahead for JO a little bit. 18-2 to the 15-0 of Arteezy. Really farming well. Bloodseeker is one of the better attack animations and pretty good base damage. You couple that with a Quelling Blade, it's actually hard for this hero to die. What I'm curious about is how aggressive EG will be in the mid game once they have Rupture. Who are they going to look to gank, and where will those ganks happen? There's some very vulnerable heroes in this game. Obviously, Keeper Light's the big one. If he gets caught by Bloodseeker alone, he's dead unless he can TP out. But even a hero like Timbersaw, the Timber Chain, he can take Rupture damage through that, so could be problematic for him. We'll have to see. For the time being, Demon, back to the bottom lane. He's not to be thwarted yet. They've deployed a Sentry Ward. I believe they unblocked the camp with this. I don't actually know if Demon warded it. Didn't see one there, but must have, judging by the Sentry. And they've been pulling freely. So now already come with me at level 3, which is not bad for 4.5 minutes. And especially when you consider that he ganked mid, he set up a first blood for his team. The support space count doing some decent work so far. Here goes the gank bottom lane. A charge on Demon revealing him. In comes the dust. The stun's there. EE gets it off and Demon's in a lot of trouble. He can maybe walk through these heroes. He'll buy a salve. He's going to be living armored up. He's trying to live through the dust. The dust wearing off soon, and I think it might be enough. Shadow Walk's cooling down. Demon just gets away in the nick of time. He is in the range of a Sentry Ward, just barely, but actually I think he's just out of range. But the stun hits him during the fade time. We'll be able to walk away. What a clowny game. What an amazing game it's been thus far. Now JO with phase boots up. Arteezy hitting level 6. I've seen him play this mid Timbersaw a few times now, and he doesn't take any points in Timber Chain until later. I believe he actually maxes reactive armor as well as Whirling Death. Obviously, this is the better laning build. Timber Chain doesn't do much for you in the mid lane. It will help you a lot more. It will help you a lot more ganking the side lanes. But before they gank those side lanes, they'll probably want to come with me to get close to level 6. They may even want to wait until Alk has a Shadow Blader near towards it. Not seeing any ancient stacking yet this game. We are seeing lots of jungle stacking, though. So if Envy wants to go greedy and he wants to go for an early Battle Fury, it might be possible to get away with that. EG, sure, they've got Bloodseeker, they've got Bounty Hunter, they've got decent track gankers, but ganking is always going to be dangerous. Timbersaw is a great counter ganker, so too is Clockwork, and already it's level 6 on Bone 7. Doing a nice job contesting the pull. Getting a lot more out of his offlane than Demon is. Demon's only level 3, so call that a big victory for Kaipe. The mid lane, 32-5 for JO, 29-2 for Timbersaw, very even, but here comes a gank. They want to kill off JO. Remember, he's got Rupture. In comes Arteezy. He'll throw the Chakram soon, I imagine. Not just yet. Now your stun comes through. Bashed, but is it enough? There's another Illuminate. They bring JO down. 3 heroes to send mid. And this support Spirit Breaker doing a lot of work. They almost killed Demon, one spot him. They got the first blood on him. Now they set up a kill mid, and it's just been forcing Jayo to play a lot more defensively. Spiritbreaker is one of those mids. You don't run a mid to farm because the hero doesn't do that much later on. I mean, Rupture is always decent lockdown. Now that Rupture goes through BKB, it's HP removal. So no matter what, it will affect you even while you're magically immune. But, I mean, it's not a Queen of Pain. It's not a hero that's great in the team fights. Still, they'll go on Demon bottom lane. There's your stun. Now Jayo comes in. Go looks for the counter gank. Living armor. For the time being, I think Demon's actually going to live here. And Jayo's trying to find a kill on EE. He dukes it out up to 2,300 gold. Not spending his gold yet. He'll go down without spending a thing. Come with me could fall as well. The stuttering in the midst of this fight. And now they'll find come with me. They'll pick up two. 2-2 your score. 7.5 minutes in. Gold, experience, fairly even. A slight lead on both counts to Kaipi, but giving up those kills there, really hurting them. They also give Demon a level 5 off of that gank. More or less, he'll hit it soon. And they've gotten their Bounty Hunter, or rather their Bloodseeker on the board, so something for Jayo. Phase boots up, we'll see what he goes for next. At some point this game, he definitely wants a BKB. There's some stuff that goes through BKB, but Timbersaw is way too much magic damage to ignore. And you don't want to be taking Alk stuns to the face. You don't want to be taking just the Keeper of the Light Illuminates. There's a lot of things that BKB will be necessary for. We'll see when he goes for one. I think it's up to Jayo to really set the tempo here. Because truth be told, EG doesn't have a Batrider. They don't have a great initiator. A charge on Jayo mid. Illusion rune, or rather Invis rune, will go to Highlight Eye. But here comes the Pook. Man, what is wrong with my English today? The Hook, rather. Jesus Christ. They'll find Jayo. They'll pick him off. At least I'm not missing the kills, but my God. I always do it right, and then I cast with Lumi, and he throws me off. I blame Lumi for everything. While that's happening, Fear freely pushing top lane. Remember, he didn't die. He's now up to 54-8. Envy only 42-10 as that safe lane out. So definitely having the edge in terms of farm here. Leading in terms of net worth against a Grievous Greed max Eternal Envy. So he's struggling a bit. Fear not so much. Reign of Health up. Power Treads up. Now it'll be straight into the Battle Fury for him. Sitting at around 6 CS a minute. Pretty strong stuff from him. Yeah, 54, 9 minutes in. And now they'll push the middle lane. Come with me, has access to his ultimate. He's constantly carrying dust. This is so important. You're against tree. You're against bounty hunter. Now he'll charge bottom. He charges bottom right through the tower mid. Certainly not catching anyone by surprise with this. Demon's like, really? Are you actually going to dive me here? Yes, he is. Come with me. He's going for the gusto. He'll pop his dust. He stuns Demon. He's going to blow him up. Now actually stunning two. Oh my goodness. They saw that one coming a mile away and they still get the kill. However, come with me may fall here. He spent all his gold. He gets his urn. Then he goes down and Fear gets a little track gold into his pockets. This has to be a pub game. I mean, he charged directly through the tier 1 mid. And Demon just walked like 3 steps back. I guess he figured there's no way he's charging me all the way. There's just no way. Well, Demon, you were wrong. Nothing half-assed from come with me. If he's going to charge you, he's really going to charge you. So now Arteezy goes back for a chainmail. Interesting choice. I mean, is it just a casual chainmail is my question. Is it a... I believe... I'm not sure. We'll have to wait and see what he builds with this, but I don't seem to recall him going for a chainmail last time around. So a bit of a different build, and now a charge mid. They're diving Jay with the tier 2 mid. Here comes come with me. It's only 1 point charge. He's maxing the bash while that's happening, though. It's a bit of a dive bottom lane. Fear's on the hunt. Jayo's been caught in the cogs. He's taking a lot of damage from Battery Assault. Eternal Envy still in fighting condition. Jumping into Sphere. Mono Void's there. He's still not throwing it. He's getting mini stun time and again. Will he go down to the tower? Fear, a rare overextension from him. Yes, he will. And it looks like Come With Me ended up backing off mid in the end. Chooses not to dive. He picks up a Bronze Sword. Is he going Blade Mail? Are they just going mass Blade Mails this game? Yeah, we'll have to wait and see. I'm not sure what these item selections are about. They are. They're going mass Blade Mails. I'm not sure particularly why EG doesn't have a Tinker. They don't have any big AoE hero. I guess EG have a lot of heroes that want a man fight, though. They have an Anti-Mage, a Bloodseeker, a Bounty Hunter. All these heroes just want to right-click. And maybe they just plan to let themselves get ruptured and then run while Blade Mailed so that Bloodseeker takes massive damage. That's about all I can think of. That's all I got for you now. And this might be all Demon's got for us now is another death. He's been dusted out. He's been caught in the trees. Now the cogs available when he tries to run won't even be necessary. Two tracks up or not. Doesn't matter. Kaipi trying to administer a good old-fashioned pub stomp to EG. Now leading by 3.5k gold, 2.5k experience. So mass blade mails. Well, Eternal Enemy's not going for one. He's getting a Battle Fury, but... Looks like even Bone 7 might be getting in on the fun. No, guys, this is not a pub. This is actually EG versus Kaipe. This is a $10,000 online tournament. It's not the International 2 by any means. It's not the G1 League, but it's a decent chunk of change. And here comes your charge mage. And by the way, neither of these teams going to that International, so they won't be getting that money. Bembo in a lot of trouble. He's going to try to TP out. He pops his ult. Nope, he gets caught by the hook. See ya, Bembo. His shenanigans not going to happen this game. Meanwhile, Fear finding a solo kill on the Keeper of the Light. I guess the other option with the mass blade mails is every time Bambo ults, they can all pop their blade mails at once. And then maybe Bambo dies to it. Yeah, that's about either that or just running while ruptured intentionally to take massive damage. It's very unusual. What a clowny game. What a clowny game. So, scores 8-4. I think the big problem for EG is their lineup wants to split push. Anti-Mage and Prophet, that's pretty obvious, and they can't. Because of Spirit Breaker, because of the sheer mobility of a hero like Timbersaw, and especially Clockwork, who, by the way, Bone7 has really been on point this game. Offlane Clock, you compare what he is to what Demon has. Demon is level 6, and Bone7 is level 10. Great play from him. Now they go in mid on Arteezy. If they rupture him, he's got the plate mail. It's discouraging J.O. from doing a thing here. He's just running. He gets bashed. He's got to do something soon. He won't do a thing. Now Arteezy slamming himself forward, throws out the nukes. Should be able to find the kill on Demon, who's dusted up, who will go down. Okay, so the blade mail making a little more sense here. You just dive the Bloodseeker and he can't do anything. He can't rupture you. Bambo tries to TP out. Bone7 looking to cancel this TP. He'll hook him. And after the battery assault, Fierce taking a lot of damage. Look for the charge. Probably coming soon. No, Spiritbreaker dead. Scratch that thought. They will find Bambo, however. And now Fear tries to find a kill, but one more blink forward and he might end up going down. He's got to run. And it looks like he'll barely escape. Thankfully for him, there was no Spiritbreaker. Well, we've seen mass blade mails before, but never quite like this. And it looks like in the end it won't be mass blade mails. It'll just be the one. So, well, I was wrong about that, but a man can dream. Clockwork actually going for an Orchid here. So, J.O. heading towards the bottom lane, being charged for the time being. Come with me. He's on the prowl. Will there be any sort of TP reaction? Eternal Envy's coming in. He's got a Battle Fury. No Shadow Blade this game. It really seems weird to go Battle Fury. I mean, they have just such a good ganking lineup. If you had a Shadow Blade on this hero, as well as Charge, as well as the Timbersaw, you could do so much work. They'll find Bambo in the trees. Good luck getting out of dodge, Bambo. He sprouts himself. Come with me. Body is time. Will go for J.O. instead, then wants to back off and go for Bambo, but he's already used his ult. Now gets bashed. J.O. can't run. In comes Eternal Envy. Slaps and chops and brings J.O. down. Five heroes to the bottom lane. Demon says, I don't know what I'm supposed to do, and he retreats out. Meanwhile, a hook attempted. Bone7 actually hooking his own teammate. Now Bambo and Demon hiding in the trees. Come with me. Gets tracked again from the safety of the tree line. I don't know what their plan is, but these two are not killing anyone. I mean, nobody. And now they're going to get caught. Bambo's in trouble. Come with me. Does not sense him. They also don't see Demon, despite the fact that he's dusted. Now they found him. In comes the Chakram. They'll clear out the trees in a hurry. He gets blown up. EG. I mean, this is why Fear sometimes says, you know what? I just got to play Anti-Mage this game, guys, because that's the only way this is going to happen. And he's got his Battle Fury now. A 15-minute Battle Fury. Still, farming safely will be trouble. And you are farming against a Max Grievous Greed Alc with a Battle Fury of his own. You're going to fall behind. Unless Envy really overextends. J.O. comes in, finally throws out a Rupture. But, well, he'll sit in position for the time being. Keeper of the Light, sprouted, but not really taking any damage. Now throws out the Buckler. The turnaround comes. J.O. just stands there helplessly. No, he won't be running. He gets hooked. Beatus gets blown up. Now J.O. in trouble. The Battery Assault bringing him low. Is it enough to bring him down? The missile's there. It flies, and the kill is secure. Now a quick TP out from Bone7. Demon comes in, late to the party once again. In Fear we trust. That's pretty much all EG can do now. He can't really split push. If he shows himself in the lanes, he'll get charged. He'll be in a lot of trouble there. Soon Envy will have a Shadow Blade. There's even an Orchid up on Bone7, so now he needs a Mancer to be able to find kills. Demon going for the kill. They pop more dust. They pop their Orchid as well. And now Demon's in a lot of trouble. Eats a stun, gets caught in the acid spray, gets surrounded by four. He just wanted the Keeper of the Light by Pylite Eye, outplays him, pops the Blinding Light. After Demon unloaded his full nuke package, Demon couldn't get in range to right click him, couldn't do anything. Is it really going to happen again? Come with me. Charges Bambo. Did he cancel it? No, he gets a first hit bash. Bambo's TP is canceled. Now In trouble. Oh, excuse me. That wasn't a first hit bash. I believe that was the nether strike. Another bash. This time it's a lucky bash. Bam.